It is possible for market competition to be reduced through corporate mergers. Not all mergers are anti-competitive, though, and some are even efficiency-enhancing. Let's take a look at three categories of mergers. 1. Conglomerate mergers are mergers between companies with unrelated output. For example, in 1967, the Campbell's Soup Company acquired Godiva Chocolate. Did this merger affect competition in the soup market? No. Did it affect competition in the candy market? No. Conglomerate mergers do not reduce competition in either market since the products are unrelated, so the U.S. government allows them. 2. Vertical mergers are input-output mergers. This means that a firm that produces a product merges with a firm that produces a resource used in the production of that product. For example, what if that soup company acquires, say, the company that makes the cans that the soup comes in? This is actually cost-reducing, i.e. efficiency-enhancing, because, among other reasons, it cuts out the costs of the middleman. The soup company doesn't have to continually renegotiate contracts with the can producers. Because vertical mergers make production more cost-effective, the government typically has no problem with them. The one exception would be if a company was trying to acquire the sole producer of a resource, since that would result in a monopoly in the product market. For example, in 1999, there were two major competing bookstore chains on the East Coast, Borders and Barnes & Noble. Barnes & Noble put in a bid to acquire a book wholesaler, Ingram, but the government rejected the request because Ingram was the only major book distributor on the East Coast. Approval of the merger would leave the competitor, Borders, without a distributor, effectively driving them out of business. The government rejected this merger because of the monopoly that would result from it. 3. Horizontal mergers are mergers between companies that sell the same output. These are the mergers that undergo the greatest scrutiny by the government. If the merger doesn't noticeably alter competition in the industry, it's approved. But if it does affect competition, it is rejected. There's a big difference between two small companies, say each has a 1% market share, merging, versus two large companies, say one has 15% and the other has 25%, merging. The government uses industry concentration data to evaluate merger requests. The Herfindahl-Hirschman Index uses the sum of the squares of each firm's market share, or the 50 largest firms if they're more than 50, to measure industry concentration. For example, if the industry is a monopoly, then there's only one firm, which has 100% of the industry. So H equals 100 squared, or H equals 10,000. Thus, 10,000 represents the highest possible index number or the highest level of industry concentration. An industry with two firms, each having 50% of the market, would have H equals 50 squared plus 50 squared, or H equals 5,000. What about an industry with 100 firms, each having 1% of the industry? Then H, the sum of the squared shares of the top 50 firms, would be 50. A Herfindahl-Hirschman index of less than 100 indicates a highly competitive industry. An HHI below 1500 indicates unconcentrated. An HHI between 1500 and 2500 is considered moderately concentrated. And an HHI above 2500 indicates a highly concentrated industry. 2500 is the U.S. threshold for mergers. One potential weakness in using the HHI is that the index can vary based on how the applicant defines the industry in the request for merger. For example, in 1997, McDonnell Douglas and Boeing merged. You would think that, being the two largest aerospace companies in the U.S., such a merger would be rejected, but the companies argued that the applicable market was global, not just domestic, so that foreign companies constituted part of the market in question. Thus, the Federal Trade Commission said that Boeing's acquisition of McDonnell Douglas would not substantially lessen competition or tend to create a monopoly in either defense or commercial aircraft markets, and the merger passed the industry concentration hurdle.